I think one of the things I did want to ask a bit more about is at the recent BRICS summit that was held in Johannesburg, there was something came up within the BRICS summit, and we've also seen President of Rwanda talk about it, and you know, Prime Minister of Ethiopia, about this whole idea of free movement within Africa and the entire visa situation. What are your thoughts around about there being more free movement, just for the average person, if you're not somebody who's into trade, for example, but just to be able to travel in order to boost tourism? What are your thoughts around, should I say, a visa-free Africa?
I told you earlier that our visa regimes in all our embassies is very flexible. Flexible in the sense that provided you're going there for genuine business and or you are a tourist, we're encouraging, come. There is no way. God created human being. He didn't cage him. He asked him to move around, go and procreate and conquer and multiply and create the world. That's what he said. So we don't exhibit. And then this movement within Africa, young Africans will be able to visit each other, go there, understand, interact, interrelate, know and study the culture, the way, the lifestyle of the people, what abounds there. And these ones grow up with ideas. Oh, I saw this. Why don't I go to Uganda? There is plenty of what in Uganda that I can also do business in that area. So we actually, Africa, the Pan-African movement that started long, it is something to integrate Africa. The African integration, Nepal that was sometimes mooted and then things like that. These are all ideas that to make Africa, even though a borderless continent, where we can all come together, fuse our synergy, harness our resources, and develop our, the lives of our people. If we don't do that, it is going to be a big problem. Free movement, trade and investment goes with free movement. If you hinder the people from moving, then there is a problem. That is very paramount, and that is key. The idea of free movement within African continent, in as much as we should implement it in such a way that we must be sure, let's not just because we want to integration and people to move, and then we at the end of the day, we end up having problems. So it should be gradual. We review it along the way. We take step one another. And I know, I remember my president will always say that, yes, it's not free. Nobody wants to come to Nigeria that has been forbidden. But these issues of immigration, let us have a thorough work done on it so that when it comes, you see what was happening. What's happening in the EU, even though, and this thing, and then some are now apprehensive. They want to pull out of certain things, and those are the things that we're noticing. So, but free movement between Africa is something that, with time, we must have to have it in place if we want the continent to move forward.
You also spoke a bit about the amount of young people in the youth in Nigeria. Africa has got a stat that's similar like that. I believe we're the youngest continent in the world. But we have a situation where, on one hand, some people, if you're a young person, you see a lot of opportunity within Africa, and then other people are still trying to leave Africa by any means necessary.
Oh.
So, which is, you know, by any means necessary, which is rather unfortunate. What do you think can be done in terms of African countries working together so that the skills are well used and well kept with young people so that we can grow the continent instead of skills being taken outside of Africa and people not coming back?
You are right. That is a very unfortunate issue. And I think what some African governments, including Nigeria, Rwanda, what is happening in South Africa and other some key African countries is something that is very encouraging. Encouraging in the sense that if you make the local condition, the domestic conditions very conducive for these youths to have employment, after education, if they have employment, they can develop themselves. They can even think, some of them may not want to go into public service. They will want to set up businesses that will make their lives better. And that is what we should do. And that does not come on a platter of gold. You must have the political will, the political atmosphere, to actually let a level playing ground for everybody to come in and do what he knows to do best. If you do that, you know the beauty of it? The beauty of this is that people realize their potentials. People contribute much to the system. And then you find that the economy will definitely revive itself, and it will grow, and then you have unemployment will be a thing of the past, and then the standard of living and nutritional level of the children, and then those who grow, everything, every sector and every institution in that country or in the continent will improve. But we need that synergy. I always say that Africa should use, we should not be swayed. We should interrelate more. We should use anything that another African country has comparative advantage over the other. We should patronize. We should patronize. If you patronize, for example, the railway production, this thing in the Transnet, is this Transnet in South Africa that produce coaches and things like that? If African countries patronize that, this company is bound to reinvest and then to develop whatever it's doing, its products, and give it the best standard. And therefore, likewise, if there are things that Nigeria is known to produce or to do better, other African countries should actually patronize Nigeria. That is the spirit of this thing. The AU has a lot of work to do in the area of sensitization on that. Now, coming to the issue of migration to other parts of the country, a few days ago we had attended a meeting, and I said this to one of my colleagues in this thing. I said, look, if Europe wants African states to create buffer zones where they can hold their people or migrants that they don't want to this thing, you know what they need to do? You must come and reinvest in Africa. Come to African countries and reinvest. When you create jobs in these countries, when you help national governments in this continent to develop their economy to a certain level, all these people that are young population that are migrating to other parts of the world will stay back. They will stay back. So it's not something of either a legislation or you want to either put them or people coming to seek asylum or economic whatever. No. Come and make the conditions here, this thing. And please, if leaders don't have ideas on how to develop their countries, don't support them to remain too long. Government. Let other people this thing. You just gave me an example of Ethiopia.
Yes.
These are pride peoples that are working. And you have people like also in the in Rwanda, people like the president here also, he is so foresighted, he is concerned about the economy. So we should always make sure that our leaders are focused on the economy, and that is indirectly impacting on the standard of life of people. Why will I want to go to Europe? For what? If everything that I want, or I'm giving 70% of what I want down this, if I want business, I have access to the facilities to do my business, to exhibit my talents. Why? What will take me to Europe? And what we need to do also is enlightenment. Home governments must enlighten its citizens that gold mine in Europe is no longer there. It's drying up. It's as dried. So you better stay back. I don't know of any continent that is as rich in terms of natural resources like Africa currently. And that is why you find that they will continue to come, and they will come. We must insist that some of these products that they can actually establish industries to produce them locally, so that the value chain will go a long way in developing our economy, must be established in this thing, and not for us to continue to ship raw materials abroad into develop other economies, and we continue to see our youths desperately at the cost of their lives sometimes trying to cross abroad just to make ends meet. And I think that's very unfortunate.